So, yeah, I have to ask, have you ever stopped and actually watched the moonrise? A few people. I watched one such moonrise. I've watched many moonrises, actually, and I'm always amazed by the beauty of it. And back in 2012, I was watching one such moonrise over the Mount Victoria lookout in Wellington. And it revealed the silhouettes of all these people up there. And that moment was when the idea of full moon silhouettes originated. It took me a year of chasing this moon around and failed attempts trying to get this moonrise. But finally, on this perfectly clear and amazing evening back in January, end of January 2013, I managed to film this moonrise like no other. Now, I uploaded this video to the internet, and it just went viral. I started getting thousands of emails from people all over the world. And this included emails from, you know, the mainstream media wanting to have, you know, interviews with me. And I had all these skeptics saying, well, you know, you faked it. It's all false. It's not real. And then I had astronomers and academics and scientists, and they're all doing the maths. And to their surprise, their calculations matched the moonrise almost perfectly. But the thing is that the most amazing emails I actually got, the most amazing and memorable emails I got, were just from ordinary people. People from all over the world who just wrote to me to thank me and wanted to share their experiences of watching full moon silhouettes. And some of these experiences were incredible, and they were very personal experiences. I remember a few in particular. There was one from a mother, and she said her daughter had sent her the video to watch. They'd had a major, you know, breakup, if you call that a breakup, and they just hadn't spoken to each other for like 5 years. And the mother watched the video, and after she watched the video, she called her daughter up and said, hey, you know, I want to come over and we can talk about this. So they watched the video again, and then they just spent the rest of the day sort of reconciling the differences. Another incredibly sad email came from a woman in the UK, and she was terminally ill. She simply told me she was in her last stages of life, but full moon silhouettes had given her the hope and strength to hold on longer, just so she could spend more time with her friends and family. Now, that email really hit home for me. It's, you know, how are you supposed to respond to something like that? And I just couldn't believe the response full moon silhouettes was getting. You know, it's something I certainly didn't expect, and at first I just didn't understand why. What did all these people see in full moon silhouettes? And why did so many want to share their personal experiences with me? It seemed like people felt a connection between their own lives and the video, and they put themselves in that simple moment of watching the moonrise. It was incredible. Like, out of all the people who emailed me, there were so few that had actually watched the moonrise. And then that got me thinking, why do I love taking imagery of the night sky so much? I mean, you can get some really cool photos and really impress your friends with it. But honestly, astrophotography would have to be the most frustrating form of photography there is. You're dealing with remote locations miles from anywhere, taking photos in complete darkness, all hours of the night. And there's so many variables that can go wrong. And that includes, you know, the sometimes local wildlife that, you know, doesn't like you. I had this crazy fur seal, just felt really threatened by my tripods. And that was an interesting experience. But the thing is, just being there, standing under the stars, you know, just looking up these millions of stars, far outweighs any of those challenges. So take a look at this picture. It's Cape Palliser on the North Island of New Zealand, not far from where I live. I just remember this moment vividly. I woke up and I went to go and check on a time-lapse that I was shooting up at the lighthouse. And when I woke up, I was just taken aback by the scene in front of me. The Milky Way was low in the sky, just projecting from the lighthouse. And it was at that moment I felt like I was the only person on Earth, under a sky of millions of stars. I'm not personally religious. Some people are, I'm not. But it was certainly a spiritual experience, and it had me buzzing for the rest of the next day. And that's what I try and convey in my astrophotography. You know, it's something that I try and take, and the camera does capture more than what the naked eye can see, but these images are real. You know, they're my experiences in the moment, and they reflect the way I saw the scene in front of me. You know, to add to this, there are so many mind-boggling facts about the Milky Way galaxy. The galactic core of the Milky Way, like you see in this image here, that's that big white bright thing there. It's 27,000 light years from Earth, and the mind-boggling fact about that is the light from that galactic core left back in the Stone Age period of Earth, and it finally got to us now. And beyond that, there's billions of stars in our own Milky Way galaxy, and we only really see a fraction of those, just a small fraction. And apart from that, there is hundreds of billions of galaxies within our known universe. Now, to get your head around these things, it's certainly not easy, and I still struggle with it myself. But being under the stars is a great place for learning. My 8-year-old son, as you see us geeking out in the picture there, he loves coming out with me, and we look up at the night sky, and we talk about all sorts of things. And it's amazing how inquisitive a mind can be under the right learning conditions. And I believe the youth of today should be exposed to opportunities like this. So the simple fact is, you know, in today's world, fast-paced world, our lives are ruled by technology and longer working hours and less family time. We rarely stop to think of the simple things in life. And I think that's what full moon silhouettes did. It made people stop, look up, and enjoy. And astrophotography, for me personally, I spend many nights looking up at the night sky in awe of how small we are in the grand scheme of things. So I challenge you, stop, look up, and enjoy. Our night sky is one simple but amazing thing that's free for all. Thank you. Yeah.